gather around. Back in the day, in my day, there was a newspaper comic. Now, I'm not going to get into the newspapers and the anyway. It was called The Far Side. It was the king of them all. It was so weird and so spot on. And then the cartoonist called it quits. But now it's coming back
after 25 years. Like 1995, Gary Larson was like, "I'm done. I'm out." And then we were like, never heard from him again. But right? Like we were like, what about The Far Side? If you were anywhere between 1980 and 1995, if you were alive, you know about The Far Side. It was the coolest of the cool. Look, this is in the New York Times this morning. The Far Side is back, sort of. Gary Larson will explain. So Larson has launched a new website, and he is hinting there's going to be some new material, like new comic panels. So I went to the website. Here it is. Very easy to find, thefarside.com. It includes daily selections of some classic panels every day, new panels that he selects himself, and they republish. He's never had a website before. And then if you go to the About section and you read it closely, there's this line. Beginning in 2020, the site will commemorate the 40th anniversary of the strip with new works.
New Far Sides.
That's right. New Far Sides will be sprinkled in at his leisure. The site also is going to show off never-before-seen sketches from his sketchbook. So new panels, new sketches, stuff we've never seen before. I mean, it's kind of exciting.
Yeah, Gary Larson was the commencement speaker at Washington State University when I went there. He's
That's so
Coug
cool.
and a local guy.
Right, 72, Wazoo Coug. Born in Tacoma. I didn't realize that. I knew he was a Wazoo guy. Also lives in Seattle now, apparently. He and his wife live here. What's funny is he apparently debuted, as far as I understand it, the comic in the Seattle Times. And it didn't go over super well. Maybe we just weren't ready for it yet. So he took his game to San Francisco, and that's where it was syndicated, and it was in a San Francisco newspaper. But he came back, and he lives in Seattle now. And that's where he's, helping run the new thefarside.com.
It's